Lord Commander, if I may, I wish to speak with you before the Grand Melee.
Proceed.
How do you do it, my lord? How do you lead with such certainty when so many of our countrymen will not hear of peace with the Dravanians? Some of them hate you almost as much as the dragons themselves. They decry you as a patricide in the streets. They even tried to kill you, for God's sakes. Yet still, you march on, undaunted, where no archbishop dared to tread. What is your secret? Where do you find the strength?
For centuries, our nation has been punished for the sins of our forefathers. If our punishment is to end, I believe we must right the wrongs of antiquity and move forward as a nation united. Needless to say, my father did not share this opinion. He did not believe the people strong enough to bring about their own deliverance, trusting only in himself. Tyranny seemed to him the only solution. But I have faith in the people, Lord Amanalain. I have faith that they will weather this storm and overcome every trial we set before them. Many have fought and died to see this blight upon our nation's history cleansed, and I would not let their sacrifices be in vain. Though we invite reprisals, the risk is worth the reward.
I want to believe. I do. Lord Commander, through my careless orders, a pall has been cast over these proceedings, and I beg the opportunity to make amends. I, Amanalain de Forton, do hereby request leave to take part in the Grand Melee.
Who am I to deny such a heartfelt plea? We would be honored to have you join the fray, my lord.
You'll take charge of the Ishgardian forces.
For all my other responsibilities, I am still Lord Commander of the Temple Knights, and I would not soon yield this duty to another.
The esteemed Sir Emmerich leading the Temple Knights and the Watch into battle along with my youngest. I could wish for no more.
Then you wish for too little, my lord. There is another who might yet join the fray. An indispensable ally to whom we owe much and more. An adventurer beholden to none who nevertheless chose to champion our cause, who has shared in our suffering and in our glory. A warrior without equal, who I am privileged to call a friend. There is no one I would rather have fighting by my side. I ask this in full knowledge of your obligations, and will not think less of you should you refuse. But if your conscience will allow it, might you oblige me, my friend, one more time. Together we shall give the people a spectacle for the ages, a celebration to mark the dawning of a new era.
Thank you. Let all here present heed well the rules of engagement. For the honor and the glory of Ishgard.
All is ready then. Very well. Of the Eorzean Alliance, let the grand melee begin!
Yeah. here!
Right there!
Did he win? Then we...
Victory is ours! Ishgard! Ishgard! Well fought! Well fought, my friend! You truly are the warrior of warriors.
Thank the fury you were on our side.
My lungs are burning, and I can barely stand. I didn't think I could do it, but then I did. We did. We faced the Alliance's best, and together, with one heart, with one purpose, we prevailed. After 1,000 years of hardship, of strife and bloodshed, we are strong enough to rise to any challenge, be it on the battlefield or beyond. The future holds so much promise, so much joy. We need only show them the way.
Magnificent display, Sir Knight. While doubtless less than pleased, I am quite sure the Grand Companies are honored to have been bested by such valiant warriors.
The honor was ours, Your Grace.
I am pleased to see that Ishgard's proud martial tradition is being upheld. When the time comes, I trust you will fight alongside your brothers and sisters in the Eorzean Alliance with the same fervor you displayed in opposing them. I note that our friend elected to take the field in Ishgardian colors.
At my behest, Your Grace, if we have given offense, the blame lies with me.
Sir Knight, it was a surprise, nothing more. And any hint of ill feeling was thoroughly dispelled by the spectacle of our mutual friend's duel with General Rauban. On the subject of surprises, I could not help but marvel at the passion and unity of purpose displayed by your countrymen, given the troubling reports we have received of late.
I shall take that as a compliment, Your Grace. The events to which you allude are the price of change. The end of the Dragonsong War marks the beginning of a new era for our nation, and for the people, high and lowborn alike, who will lead her into the future.
Ah, yes. The people. Change is indeed a perilous thing. For we who seek it, and they who fear it. I shall pray for Ishgard, and for you.
Well, that made for a refreshing change. Congratulations on your victory, by the way. Ishgardians certainly seem happy with themselves. I, for my part, am merely glad you did not strain anything in the process of single-handedly winning the battle for them. Tis but a scratch, I assure you. And I will not suffer you to worry over me. Not when we have a dozen far more important concerns. Make that 24. Still, as Ystola never tires of telling me, we can but face them head on, one at a time.
One day at a time. As Minfilia would have done.